in the gym with them kids, man. He stayed in there with them kids. And look at the results he brought back out of it.
One of the best pound-for-pound fighters on the planet, the most exciting fighter that sells out arenas everywhere. Every celebrity, every rapper, every NBA player, every football player, they're all texting and tweeting and posting him. By the way, did you have a chance to talk to Madonna at the fight?
No, I ain't see Madonna, but what's his name? He had the talk show. He was right behind me, and I kept looking at him. He
Yeah,
was a football player.
William Tracy Morgan.
He was a
Oh, you're
football
talking about
player. He
Michael
played
Strahan. Yeah, I saw Strahan.
Michael Strahan, man. He kept looking at me, right? So I went to the wax museum and took a picture with him, with his with what you call it. And I'm gonna post it in a minute. You know, and tag him in it. Like I was paying attention
Hey,
to him, but he was.
I'm not gonna lie, Calvin. I saw him box. He needs your help. He can't box to save his life. He was doing some segment about boxing. It just looked bad. So maybe you
He
can help
did.
him.
Maybe he might reach out to me, but he looked at me, and you can tell me he looked at me and gave me the nod, like, "Yo, y'all about y'all work." You
Yeah,
know, so that
and
was a good
Calvin,
thing.
it's I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of Tank because it's so hard to make it in boxing. Not only from the athletic side, from the business side, it's hard. It's a hard sport. Not
It is.
nobody believes in you till you make it. When you make it, everyone loves you. But the way
Right.
up is not easy. And
Nah,
you
man.
guys didn't have it easy. People think everything is easy, but you traveled on the road a lot. I remember you fought in Washington, you fought in Connecticut, you guys fought in all kinds of places. And the one first time Tank didn't get a knockout, I think that was in a casino in was it upstate in Northern California, I
Yeah,
think.
it was. And Tank could have got the knockout. The dude actually said, just a little bit more, I was going to quit. And Tank was all bloated. And I told him not to eat certain things. No, I want, this is what I want. And he ate it. He was in the corner. And I wish I could find that picture with that video, man. Every time he came to the corner, I didn't give him no instructions. I said, see, you shouldn't have ate what you ate. That's why you feel the way you feel. You know?
Speaking of weight, Calvin, he came in at 133. Wasn't that great?
Man,
And he looked comfortable and healthy. He didn't look drained or dried out. He looked comfortable.
Like I keep telling you, that boy can make 130, 135, but he's strong at 135 too. You seen that shot he threw? Man, that shot was, yo, that shot. I was listening to another, what you call it, and they were saying all the fighters that spar Tank, that no Tank, that was, you know, giving their prediction of the fight. And one of them sitting there said, man, Tank got that pop, man, that you don't know is coming. And when he pop you with it, it's like you done. You know? And they spar Ron. They say Ron got that pop. Then they go, boom. They say,
Ryan,
that Tank,
last camp, listen, last camp, Ryan broke the jaw of one sparring partner with headgear. And all the other sparring partners hit the floor. He has power, he has speed.
No,
people
he
don't
can
give him
punch.
Credit, but he's a good fighter.
No, to tell you the truth, he the real deal with that. He got that I call it that mental retarded strength.
Ryan?
He definitely got that. Yeah. He definitely got that, man. So again, we used this on him. You know. We knew he was lacking this.
No,
you're talking about 17? Rollie. Yeah, Rollie. 17? That's my tank. I said 17? You gonna beat me? I got too much experience.
Yeah, no, it was a great event. Listen, the great lead-in, everything was perfect. The weigh-in, the push, just helped sell more pay-per-views. And like I said, the crowd, I don't know if you can notice it, when Tank walked out, you were in the ring, everyone were on their feet for the first two rounds. No one sat down.
Yeah, nobody sat down. Friends of mine were saying they couldn't even see. Everybody was standing.
Yeah. So what did Tank yell at Teofimo during the fight in the fifth round? He turned around and he yelled something.
I don't know. I think because, you know, him and what's his name, good friends. And I think he was yelling something at Tank. So Tank yelled back at him, you know. Because you know that, you know, Rollie and Teofimo, they good friends.
Yeah, I know.
They good friends. They good friends. So, you know, he was rooting for his boy. So Tank said something to him, you know.
So
you see how Tank is. Tank the whole conversation.
During his fight.
To a person during a fight.
So let me ask you this. Tank wanted to bet Jake Paul $2 million. Do you think?
Jake was smart. Jake was smart. He left that alone. You notice that?
Do you think Tank would have tried to collect afterwards if they bet? Or just say, oh, it was just for publicity?
Well,
just...
the type of guy Jake was, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, Tank would have collected. If he Tank, one thing about us, when we bet, we're going to pay our bet.
$2 million
That's one thing about us. Anything that we bet, like you watch one segment. One of the kids in the gym say bet $3,000. He paid the coaches. He literally had to pay the coaches.
$3,000. Wow.
Yeah. We was betting that he couldn't keep up with Tank on the Wichita. He paid it. He went. He said, I ain't got it. He said, can I get the rest of it later, coach? I said, yeah. And Tank said, no, I'll pay my coaches, yo, because you jumped out there. And he did it.
What? So I want to ask you this. Conor McGregor, do you know who he is? Are you familiar with him?
Conor McGregor, the MMA star? Yeah, I know him. I was at Floyd and him fight.
Okay. Tank was there. Okay, yeah. So he recently said that his first love is boxing. And that he sees himself coming back for a boxing match. Would you be open for Conor McGregor to come train in Baltimore at your gym to help him?
Man, without a question. Like I say, one thing about Conor McGregor, he got heart. And the way we train, you got to add that. And, you know, but again, you can't rush him into situations. You got to develop him. Just like a person just starting to ride a bike. And see, is he getting the system? It's a system. That's why I say something about Wilder. Wilder was doing things in that last fight that I liked. But for some reason, he went away from it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he was went winning. To the body of Fury. Fury didn't know what to do.
Right, he was doing some things that he went away from. And I couldn't understand how did that happen? You know what I'm saying? Maybe the corner changed it up, you know, but they should have stuck on him because he was winning the first three, four rounds. He was actually winning the fight.
Yeah. Fury may be retired right now, so the whole heavyweight division should be wide open once he gives up his belt.
Yeah, it's going to be amazing. You know what I'm saying? I still would like to see Joshua and Wilder fight.
That's going to happen after Joshua beats Usyk. Watch.
So you really think he's going to beat him?
Yep.
Okay. That's the one he lost to, right?
Yeah, that's the one he lost to last time. He tried to box him where he's so big and strong. He doesn't need to box him.
But again, did the corner tell him to box him?
I don't know. I didn't ask the corner.
But you understand what I'm saying? And that's another thing. You got to hear what the corner's telling them so you can actually see is the guy listening to the corner.
Most fighters, do they listen to their corners? Yes or no? What do you think?
Well, I have some. When you don't hear me saying nothing, that means the fight ain't what? Listening. So what's the use of me saying anything?
Yeah. So that if a fighter listens, usually there's a reason that it works. But sometimes fighters want to do their own thing.
Yeah. I'm like this. If a fighter doing his own thing and it's working, I'm all with it. But if a fighter ain't listening to the corner, what's the point you have a corner? Everybody know if I work the corner with you and you ain't listening, you're going to get a silence treatment to me. You might not get no water from me.
They're not getting water. They're getting water from someone else.
Yeah, reason why? Because you put me in the corner to trust my judgment.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So, Calvin, how do you summarize this whole experience in New York? I mean, it was a major fight. It was a big – I was happy that Rolly talked trash because it helped sell. Tank didn't have to carry this fight on his own shoulders like he normally does.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Well, you know, Rolly had a personality. And like I said, what you call it? Rolly won with his mouth. You know what I'm saying? And he paid with his mouth. You get me? But again, like I said, I salute Rolly and his team. They came out, man, put on a beautiful show. They came out to win. You know what I'm saying? But again, I know my guy. I know our capability. When we go in camp, we going in the lab, deep in the lab. You know what I'm saying? Man, shucks. I can't tell you everything. I can't wait till one day when I write my book about all the camps that we had, man, and some of the tactics that we do. And you see how we get down.
No, of course. Yeah, but I will say one thing I did like. Tank thanked Rolly after the fight, and Rolly thanked Tank the next day. And you said that Rolly's dad came in the locker room. What was he telling
you? I love him, man. I love his dad. Classy. And then you heard it in the All Access. He said both of them crazy, and both of them got power. Somebody going to sleep. That's boxing. And he came in there. He said, Coach, where your man at? I took him in there. He shook his hand. He said, man, great fight. Man, love y'all both. You know what I'm saying? Enjoy your win. That was classy right there.
Okay, that's what boxing's all about. It's a sport. You can have disagreement. You can have some, like, genuine hate. But when it's all said and done, you squash it and you move forward.
And you move forward. You know? Because Tyson says sometimes y'all might need each other. Sometimes y'all do.
So are you and Bullet? You and Bullet, are you guys cool now?
Man, Bullet was always cool. I just try to explain to Bullet. Man, when we was going doing the drug, I mean doing the gloves, I told Bullet, I said, Bullet, this is not about us. We show our work in the ring the night of the fight of what we've been training these guys. And then when I got in there and talked to Bullet, I said, now you see my work, but Bullet already know how I get down because he came in the gym and watched me train. Whipped out his camera and watched the things that I do. You get what I'm saying? He told me, he said to me, like, yo, you really be into it. You been too. You get what I'm saying? So it's not, it was no hard feeling. It just got to a point. It sounded like Bullet was mad with Tank more than, you know, more than anything when the beef was, and not even the beef, the fight was Tank and him. You know what I'm saying? But I understand business and whatnot. It's just business, you know? At the end of the day, it's just business.
Entertainment industry. You
know?
You have to be entertaining besides, it's not.
Yeah, you know, just, at the end of the day, he shook my hand. He shook my hand. I shook his hand. You know, shucks. At one point, the fight didn't even go on when we was at the glove table. You know what I'm saying? You know, trying to figure the goddamn gloves out.
Why? Because, what happened? What happened at the glove selection?
Oh, man. Well, Kenny was watching the gloves, you know, because I normally pick his gloves out, but this time, Tank didn't try the gloves on. And I'm like this. You got to fight in the gloves. You got to test the glove up. So I said, well, let me do this. I had two different types of pair of gloves. Get what I'm saying? But I understood what gloves that I wanted Tank to wear. And Kenny liked it, the other pair of gloves. And I was just saying, them gloves are good. But right now I'm in a situation I have to be sure that I don't have no hiccups in this fight. You know what I'm saying? So the gloves that Tank had on that night was the perfect gloves that I needed him to wear that night. You know what I'm saying? And he wore them. And you've seen the results from them gloves. You know what I'm saying? And he had no problems with his fists. None. Yeah.
Listen, after the fight, Calvin, I did a poll on my page, and over 50,000 people voted, maybe 60,000, 70 already. Where do you put Tank on your pound-for-pound list? 11% picked him number one. About 20% picked him 1 through 3, and 22% 1 through 5, which is 50%, 51% of the people have Tank 1 through 5. And I'm talking about, this is not 3 people voting, this is 50,000. So I'm glad he's finally getting his respect that he should have been getting for the last 5 years, ever since he beat Pedraza.
Yeah, he should have got that when he beat Pedraza, because you had a young kid come from out nowhere and be a undefeated world-class champion. You know?
And then moved up and won another title afterwards, so he was game. It's not like he caught him in the end of his career.
After he did that, he went overseas and fought a dude.
I was there.
Right. Then he came back. Fought, lost his title, went and fought again and got his title back, and been moving since, and went up in weight class.
Yeah. Barrios, nobody gave him a shot. I love how everybody tells me now, oh, we picked him to win. No, you didn't, because I interviewed everybody. And look, Thurman didn't stop Barrios. Tank did.
Yeah, that says a lot right there.
That's true. So
that
Calvin,
says a lot.
I want you to tell everybody, give everybody a message. How you feeling? How's Tank doing? And what did you think, by the way, of Tank's new car? I was very impressed with that Tank.
The truck.
The Rhino.
Oh, man. I like the color he put on it. That color looks good. It was a different color at first. He hooked it up. That joint rugged. That's a Tank. That fits him. That's a Tank.
I want to see him ride into the ring on it. Hold it on the side and ride it into the ring.
Yeah. That how Tank's feeling, I know he's feeling good because all the stuff that I talked to him about and where we are at in life with this boxing, I can't believe it. And we're not finished because it's a mission that we have to do to show all the youth, if you put the right team around you and believe in your team and believe in what you do, anything is possible. That's the message.
That's true. So there you have it. By the way, shout out to Jay Leon Love. He's here with us. Coach Calvin Ford. Stay tuned, and can't wait for the next one. Hopefully in the next 3 months, another fight. I'm Ellie Sekback. Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.